Welcome back to another tutorial. Today we're going to teach you all about slowing down your clips as smoothly as possible.
We have some footage of our awesome flip, and we'll show you different ways of applying variable speed effects to achieve a cool look. To apply a basic variable speed change, we'll select a clip and navigate to the retime pop-up menu under the viewer. First, we'll try the speed ramp to zero option. This will gradually slow the clip down over time. Or if we try speed ramp from 0%, this will have the clip start out slow and speed up near the out point. We can drag these retime handles to fine-tune the speed percentages of the speed ramp segment. We also have the option of changing the end frame of an individual speed segment. This lets us choose exactly where we want a specific speed segment to end, without adjusting the value of the speed change. In this example, the first speed segment is slowed down to 13%, and the second segment is slowed to 38%. To change the end frame, double-click the transition between the speed segments, and click on the Source Frame Edit button. A film strip icon appears over the end frame of the speed segment. We can drag the film strip icon left or right to choose a different end frame. The viewer will display the end frame as we drag. We'll choose this one. Notice that the value of both speed segments remain unchanged. And now the first speed segment will end sooner, and the second segment will last a little bit longer. Let's review the change.
Let's kick it up a notch, shall we?
Let's take this footage and apply a custom variable speed change to make it look even more awesome. To do this, position the playhead at a frame where we want the clip to slow down. Select the clip, then click on the Retime pop-up menu, and choose Blade Speed or use the shortcut Shift-B. The retime editor will appear, and the clip is divided into two segments at the playhead position. Now we can drag these retime handles to change the speeds of the segments. We'll drag the playhead forward to where we want to end the slowdown. Then, we'll apply another blade speed. Next, we'll adjust these handles. We want to slow down the jump itself and speed up the other segments to really maximize the contrast in this footage. Let's check it out. For more on how to fine-tune your variable speed effects, we recommend checking out our speed transitions video linked below.
That concludes our broadcast on how you smoothly slow things down in Final Cut Pro.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
What's that? What's this? Pixel Film Studios supplying free tutorials for Final Cut Pro.